This beard has got to go. I'm getting so sick of it, it's getting ridiculously long. But first, I'm gonna do something else. Just wait, I'm gonna shave it off by the end of this video, I promise. So I know my beard is insanely long and I haven't been the best at communicating with you all lately. No, I'm not dead or living in a cave in the mountains. I just decided that I needed a break. I was getting overwhelmed with the pressure of being a YouTuber along with all the other crazy stuff that's happening in my life and generally around the world. I needed to put the cameras down so that I could take a step back, evaluate everything and just be with myself for a while. It's just me organizing this project after all, and sometimes that can feel like a lot. I'll remind everyone that I've been unable to leave Mexico during this period in time. So making enough money to survive, let alone continue to run Route del Sol at full steam, has been almost impossible. YouTube money and any other legal income source I can scrape up is all I have. My bank accounts are drained and I don't have enough money at the end of the month to cover rent and buy food to feed myself. It has been a long time since money was this scarce in my life. I once promised myself that I'd never get to this dependent position again, but here I am. Determined to not let the dream of Route del Sol die, I'm deciding to start from the bottom and do what needs to be done. Document this renewable energy journey for the world to see, in hopes that someone somewhere will see value in what I'm trying to achieve. All right, so I've packed the van up mostly. I got all that I could get done with the resources I had here in Mexico. So I started the mammoth task of packing up the project and moving it out of the ORS workshop. All the panels are inside. I'm going to show you that in a second. These are the frames that we had that I built to get mounted up there in some kind of way. The spare tire is inside. But yeah, this is what it looks like. That's what 70 solar panels looks like. It's been a while. What's going on?
Very good.
Very good, sir.
So we gotta get this big boy out.
Yeah, so we gotta get this big beast through this thing here. The slider gases.
Aquí poniendo la barra estabilizadora.
While I show you how we pulled the van out of the workshop, I want to make things as clear as possible for everyone. My overwhelming thought process during this time went from sadness all the way to frustration. While Hector and I don't have the same standards of prioritization and work ethic, and things were far from smooth sailing, I truly believe that we collectively did what we could to try to make things work here in Ensenada. Ultimately, we just didn't have the resources, financially, mentally, and physically speaking, to pull all of this off. And it took me about 10 months to realize that. On one hand, I feel like a failure, and that the actions, or maybe better said, the inactions I took during the enormously long time spent here at ORS in Ensenada, are what led to my failure to launch again. I think failure is draining, and it can start to compound in our lives. Lately, it's felt like an ever-present and exponential theme in this particular passage of time. On one hand, I'd spent some amazing time with some amazing people, which could be seen as a success. But in reality, what's important to me, what drives me to be better, is to live my life with purpose. And right now, my purpose is to fix this van and drive to Argentina, proving that our future both as average individuals and more importantly as an average collective is not hopeless. But the way things were going here were far from inspiring, which is why I felt an overwhelming guilt of failure. I really feel the pressure to succeed on this journey, and I can't tell you how guilty it felt to have to explain to those who believe in me that I'm failing. But as things go, during times of deep difficulty, it seems that there was a way forward again. And And an opportunity arose for me to take the van to Miami, Florida, where a supporter of the journey, Shane, was offering me space and some resources to continue the rebuild. With nothing to lose and everything to gain, I said yes. Here's how we got to here. Shane and I have become friends over the last year. He really believes in my journey and purpose and has been helping out significantly with Root Del Sol behind the scenes. Shane called me one day asking for some advice regarding a solar power project he had in mind. I was at the workshop with Hector at the time, and Hector overheard us talking about greenhouses. Long story short is that Hector had built greenhouses and automated agriculture equipment in a past life, and Shane needed those things fabricated for his project. So I made the connection between them. Fast forward 7 months and several delayed attempts at completing the fabrication of that project. The greenhouse was ready to send over to Miami from here in Ensenada. Shane decided that we could squeeze a van in with all of that too. So we went ahead and booked a 40-foot high cube container to take the van and the prefabricated greenhouse from Ensenada, Baja, California, through the Panama Canal to Miami, Florida. Being the first time that I ever shipped something in a container, it was a bit of a side mission paying for and reserving our spot. There was paperwork on paperwork that needed buyer and seller signatures, along with advice from brokers and freight forwarders, as well as logistical services, international payments, and, well, you get the point. It was pretty complicated.
And the container is here.
Once we had the container ready to stuff and send onwards, we had to find a way to drive the van into the container while it was up on the back of a semi-trailer. In other words, we had to find a way to lift 4 tons or 9,000 pounds of van up about 5 feet high.
The first time this has been out of the shop in months and months and months. And here's the tow truck.
To do this, we hired a tow truck with a hydraulic lifting bed to get the van to the desired height. Then we had to let all the tires down to get the van to fit into the container.
Yeah.
It was a tight squeeze, but ultimately the van was able to fit in the container along with the prefabricated greenhouse parts. The doors were sealed and the container was on its 40-something day journey to Miami, Florida.
Nos vemos en Miami.
Remember at the start of the video how I made a big deal about how long my beard was? Well, the reason it got so long was because of a strange ritual that I partook during the time of the unknown. I decided I wasn't going to shave my beard until I was purposefully engaged and moving forward with the project again. When the doors of that container shut, I couldn't wait to get those clippers out and have that beard cut from my face. So I guess the moral of the story ultimately is less about complete failure and more about perseverance. When against all odds we put our average human complex behind us and take action, good things will follow. So I guess I'll just keep turning the pages and see what tomorrow has in store for me.